Hey everyone, Donovan Brown here. I recently published a video on Helm where I mentioned semantic versioning. Then it dawned on me, maybe people don't know what that means. So in this video, I'm gonna break down semantic versioning. Let's go.
Good morning, everyone. No, let's try that again. Good morning, everyone. Oh, perfect.
Semantic versioning is a way for library developers to communicate with those that use the library. It indicates the type of changes since the last release, and if there are changes that break backwards compatibility. This is very important to communicate to library users, because breaking backwards compatibility might require code changes for the consumer. Semantic versioning has a defined structure and rules that dictate how the version changes. The structure requires a major version, followed by a minor version, and lastly, a patch version. Each part is a non-negative integer with no leading zeros. The type of changes since the last version dictate which portion of the version you increment or reset. Let's work through an example, starting with version 0.1.0. Having a major version of 0 signifies initial development and that anything may change at any time. Every release should have a unique version. This is important so that when users provide you feedback or bug reports, you can identify the exact version they were using. Let's assume we're on our third initial release with version 0.3.0. The next change introduces a backwards compatible bug fix, but does not add new functionality. The version of this release must be 0.3.1. It lets all consumers know this contains a bug fix and is safe to upgrade to because it contains no breaking changes. Once I realized that changes in the patch version meant bug fixes, I started updating my libraries more frequently when I saw the patch version change. If I know the release fixes bugs, why would I not upgrade? The library developer returns to adding new backwards compatible functionality. When the next release is ready, they must update the minor version to 4. The rules of semantic versioning state that all the values to the right of the number incremented must be reset to 0. Therefore, the next version must be 0.4.0, incrementing the minor version by 1 and resetting the patch version to 0. If their next release only contains backwards compatible bug fixes, the next release must be 0.4.1. As initial development slows and we want to start getting feedback on what will be version 1.0.0, we need a way to allow people to test this version but signify these are early bits and breaking changes might be introduced before the normal release. We can do that by adding an optional pre-release version. For example, 1.0.0-RC.2 for a second release candidate, for example. You add a pre-release by appending a hyphen and dot separated identifiers after the patch version. Identifiers only allow ASCII alphanumeric characters and hyphens. Notice that when we incremented the major version from 0 to 1, all the values to the right were reset to 0. The final optional version that you can add is build metadata. Build metadata is added by appending a plus and dot separated identifiers after the patch or pre-release version. Let's review the rules, assuming you have released version 1.0.0. As before, bug fixes will increment the patch version. New backwards compatible features will increment the minor version and reset the patch version. The only time you must release a 2.0 version is if you make changes that break backwards compatibility. As a consumer of the 1.0.0 release, any 1.x version should be safe. Nevertheless, whenever you take a new version, you should test that your code continues to function as expected. If you are considering upgrading to a new major version, read the release notes carefully to see what code changes you may have to make. In this video, we covered the structure of semantic versioning and the rules for when each part should be incremented or reset. Check the links in the description for information on how precedence is handled when comparing versions. Until next time.
No, let's try that again. Good morning, everyone. Oh, perfect.